Hello, my friends. Welcome to another quick trick record of the day type of thing. My name is Ellsworth, also known as Jonas Wakefield. Today, surprise, surprise, I got one of my favorites. And surprise, surprise, it's from back in the day. Today, we're going to talk about BM Funkster, and that's by the mighty Aphrodite. Aphrodite is a permanent part of drum and bass, and throughout the years, the tracks that he has made, oh man, they've been a cornerstone to my style. I could talk for a long time about what this man's body of work has meant to my style, but I want to get into this tune, so we'll get to the other bits a little bit later. Check it out. I've talked a lot about when I first started DJing, I was playing a lot of house parties and stuff, so it was important to have things that would get the attention of a crowd that wasn't into electronic music. And this is a weapon right here. Great beginning, little orchestra stabs, funky little steppers, but it gets there quick, check it out. It's already got funk to it, but when the bass line comes in, it's very familiar. How cool is that? I'm not even gonna talk, this is just my joint right here. Yeah, buddy. So, if you've ever heard an Aphrodite tune from this era, this isn't very unfamiliar, this section. You know, the long, slidey, jump-up style bass line. It's textbook Aphrodite from the late 90s. Obviously, that intro bit, it's not an exact sample, but it's certainly aping, check my notes here, the OJs, For the Love of Money. We've all heard that money, money, money with that ill bass line. It's not a direct sample, but it's pretty close. And you also hear the horns coming in out of there during that main bit. That was, I don't know the original sample, but it's whatever they used to do Let Me Clear My Throat. Classic hip hop tune from the Tunnel days. This stuff is always very accessible. I've said it before covering other songs that he did, but there's a lot of room here for people to enjoy it. You could scratch over this, you could put an acapella over this. This stuff is very simple, and I've never had anybody kind of turn a stink eye to it when I played it at like house parties or bars or frat houses or wherever I may have found my younger self back in the day. So funky. So stuff like this, came out in 99, and stuff like this and like Def Jammer and just that whole era of Aphrodite became kind of like the bones of how I began to understand what this music and all music really functions around, at least 4/4 music. I had no background in music. People tried to teach me, you know, in elementary school and stuff, what a measure and a stanza. None of it ever stuck. It still didn't fucking stick. But this kind of stuff was so simple that I couldn't help but grasp it. And I used to take songs like this, or, you know, anything that had this kind of structure from Aphrodite. Hang on. That let me clear my throat shit. I forgot I did this. Just keeps on giving. Right now it's like broken a little bit, so if you were to mix right here, it's got room to breathe and still maintain the old elements from this track. Man, it's well made. Just simplicity at its finest, man. I love Aphrodite for that. This era, man, I don't know if I would have gotten into DJing if it wasn't for this style. I mean, bare bones outro. Anything you put over this is gonna shine, but still have those little marks to it, man. That's how it should be done. DJ friendly shit. God bless them. Hell yeah. Alright, so, as I began to say before, that style, this style of drum and bass really helped me to understand the simple structure of this music. And when I got into more techie shit, like, the biggest example would be Remark. Remark is one of the kings of the Amen, you know, slashes it to absolute atoms and then reorganizes it into this maelstrom. And he was my first big introduction into amen-based jungle music. And I couldn't get my head around it. I had no idea where the beat recycled. I had no idea how to interpret this absolute just fucking cacophony, you know? So I started taking stuff like this, which is very simple, boom bat, not a lot of other stuff to interfere with me listening, and layering it over the Remark stuff so I could hear how that was traveling over the boom bat structure of this, if that makes sense. It helped me to decode the more complex music out there. It helped me to kind of speak amens, is what I used to say. And it helped a lot. And I told Remark that and Aphrodite that on different occasions, actually. And I think Remark appreciated it more than Aphrodite did. I wasn't trying to take anything away from him. He made some great amen tunes too, a little bit earlier than this. But his career has always kind of followed his own path, and I wasn't trying to say that his music wasn't cerebral or anything. It's just, it's different. This is music for your ass, you know what I mean? Just flat out, this is booty shaking music, man. And you know, at the heart of it, that's kind of our job as DJs, most of the time anyways, is to shake some asses, and this is a good ass shaker, man. So little info on this funky little jammer. Like I said, this is BM Funkster from Aphrodite. This came out in 1999 on V2 Records. Also had a release on G Street. I dug into it a little bit. I'm not sure if they are the same label, if one is a parent label, but they're both credited on the record sleeve, so I throw them both in there, I suppose. The B-side to this is called Rising Quince, and it's another kind of reinterpretation of a very classic, known musical snippet, which would be the melody from Passing Me By from The Far Side. So both sides of this are weapons that are worth playing, that will get the attention of anybody out there, not just your average drum and bass head, but it'll kind of dip that toe into the waters of real music and kind of let the familiarity pull you in, which is a wonderful tool to have. I will never say it enough how much I appreciate producers that kind of straddle that line and create these offerings that are just so tasty. But yeah, man, so as I said, it had that little sample in there that sounds like it's from the OJ's Love of Money. I don't believe it's a direct sample. It sounds pretty close, but if you go back and listen to the OJ's again, it's got a little more organic feel to it, like an actual bass player is playing it, versus this sounds a little too perfect. Splitting hairs, whatever. still catchy as hell. Aphrodite is a goddamn hero. One of the more confusing naming conventions out there, if you're not part of this industry or part of this fan base at least, because Aphrodite obviously was a female goddess. That's kind of redundant, sorry. A goddess. Whereas Aphrodite, the producer, very much a guy. I believe his first name is Gavin. Only met him one time. Nice enough guy. But man, what a career. Great DJ, great producer, great friend to all of us. That will about do it, my friends. Hope you enjoyed it. Aphrodite will get a lot more attention on my show, channel, whatever you want to call this. He's such a big background to my style. Breakdown patterns he uses, the funk, the hip-hop influences, just the way the man carries himself in production and the choices he makes. It's one of my favorite. He's on my Mount Rushmore of producers and a more or less buy on site artist, no matter what year you're talking about. So dig him up. I'm sure if you've listened to this channel enough, you've heard of Aphrodite at least at some point in your life. If you haven't, he's a cool motherfucker. So check him out. I'm gonna stop talking now. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I will see you very soon. Peace.